Dearest gentle reader, Bridgerton is coming back. Welcome back to my channel, everyone. I am Aurora, and this is Ramblings with Ro, where I ramble about things. And today, I'm going to ramble about the upcoming season 3 of Bridgerton. So the trailer just dropped. I'm kind of excited. I actually don't really like Colin and Penelope. No hate to the actors. Colin is just boring so far. I say so far because I am... the trailer looks promising. So I am expecting Colin to have a glow up. But Colin is like the least interesting Bridgerton brother so far. And Penelope, I don't actually like Penelope as a person. But she is very complex and I think in general a good character to have. I just don't like her. But I think both of them are redeemable, you know? Like, I think Colin has potential to be interesting. And I think Penelope also has the potential to be a better person. Also, another disclaimer. I didn't read the Bridgerton books. I only read Anthony's story and Eloise's story. But I read those books, like, so long ago. Like, I must have been 18 or 19 when I read the Bridgerton books. I'm not really a big fan of Julia Quinn. But I did like the book that she wrote, Mr. Cavendish or something. I can't remember the title right now. But it's basically about a nobleman losing his title. So that one was interesting. Colin Bridgerton actually makes an appearance in the book. Yeah. It's kind of like a reverse Cinderella story. You know, like from a poor person becoming a princess, he is a lord who loses his title and he becomes like a normal person, basically. Yeah. So anyway, enough about Mr. Cavendish. Let's talk about Colin and Penelope. So I did not read Colin and Penelope's book. Okay, let's talk about Colin first since he doesn't have that much going on in the first two seasons. So I'll talk about Colin first and then I'll talk about Penelope. When I was watching Bridgerton, my favorite Bridgerton brother was definitely Benedict. I think everybody loves Benedict. Even though Benedict's story is the third book, I was not really disappointed to hear about them putting Polin in season 3 because I feel like it'll be too drawn out if we don't get Polin's story now. So it makes sense for them to like wrap it up because the Featheringtons are already taking up a lot of space in the first two seasons, so I'd rather they just finish their story in the third season and then we can get to Benedict. Also, I hope that they give a hint of Benedict's story, like him meeting Sophie. Okay, so I do know what the books are about because I have come across the storyline so many times, especially since Bridgerton has come out. So I know what happens relatively, but the point is, I mean, these romance stories, they're all predictable, right? They have tropes. And that's not the point. The point is not to be surprised. The point is to watch the process. And I feel like people who like historical romance or period pieces, you're watching it for the slow burn, you know, the burning of the characters. Yeah. So anyway, sorry, I am going on a tangent. But yes, I understand that Benedict in the books, I know that it has been said that Benedict on screen is what Colin is like in the books. So he's a lot more charming in the books. But I think it makes sense why they don't really have that much of a setup for him in the series. I think because first of all, the book itself, Penelope is a lot of a bigger character. I think it comes from Penelope's perspective. And Colin is a baby. He's the baby of the three older brothers. So it makes sense that you don't really see a lot of him. And I think what season 3 is going to show is not just Penelope blooming from being a wallflower, but I think it's also Colin. Like, you know, Colin becoming a man. And from the baby brother to being a band. So in so far as season 1 and 2, my impression of Colin is just that he is just a boy, you know. There's nothing much going on. I think his heart is in the good place. He hasn't done anything horrendous. He is not yet leading man material, you know, versus, you know, Anthony. You have the whole, oh, responsibility, tortured, traumatized by father's death, you know, kind of trope. And then like with Benedict, you have the charming artist, right? He's a bit more hipster, right? it's always charming to watch. Yeah, Colin is just a baby. So in season 3, what I am looking forward to is Colin being a man. Kind of see his charm that people always talk about from the books. I am hoping to be wrong, basically. Like, I am hoping that I will be wrong about Polin and that he's not just boring. Yeah. But with Penelope, though, I think I have said that I do find Penelope really complex, and I think it's not very common for us to see complex female characters, I mean, in general, but like, okay, I don't think Penelope is a good person or like a good friend, but I like that she is not a good friend. You know what I mean? I like that even though she's like a wallflower, she's not like an angel. Usually wallflowers in books are like shy, reserved female characters in books. They tend to be very angelic. I like the fact that Penelope has more going on with her. First of all, in season 1, she is very self-interested. She revealed her cousin's pregnancy because of the ethics of trapping a man. The only reason why she had a problem with it was because it was Colin and because she was in love with Colin. She was happy enough for her to get married to another man and trapping him, right? It's a bit of a contradiction, or it's hypocritical of her to be okay with the act of trapping someone morally if it's somebody else other than Colin. In season 2, the thing that she did with Eloise, it, like, even though it's like to protect Eloise so that the queen won't go after Eloise, she is still essentially protecting herself. The noble thing to do would be to reveal herself, but instead she is more keen on self-preservation. And also the fact that she gossips, and she gossips about people that are close to her. And I understand that some people have said that in the books, Penelope doesn't really talk about the Bridgerton. So, like, she's more of a loyal friend, or, like, it's not so dramatic. Like, the reveal of her being Lady Whistledown is to Eloise. Like, for this one, I do like the change because Colin is already boring. If Penelope is just some sweet angel who happens to be Lady Whistledown, but then she doesn't drag the Bridgerton family, then it's gonna be another boring one. Like, too boring, 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 boring. Boring! Right? If she is too good. So I do like the fact that she is morally gray because she is self-interested. She is preserving herself. Like, even though she has money, she does not help her family when her family needs it. I mean, that's her prerogative, I feel like, for that, because they show that, you know, her family doesn't really treat her well. So I guess there's the justification in that. But I think ultimately she has to redeem herself to Eloise, and also I think redeem herself to Colin, because like the actions that she made as Lady Whistledown does affect Colin as well. I don't know how she's gonna redeem herself with Eloise. That is what I'm interested to see. Like, I'm interested to see her relationship with Eloise. Speaking of Eloise, so we see Eloise being friends with Cresta, and it's like, why? I'm interested to know why? Like, even though you're in the season and you don't have your best friend anymore, yeah, fine. But why does it have to be Cressida? Like, why? Like, is it to specifically annoy Penelope or make Penelope jealous? You know? But yeah, why? Okay, so we have, okay, I said Colin, okay, Penelope, Eloise. I'm sorry, Polin, but like, the thing that I'm looking forward to the most in season 3 is just to see married Kate and Anthony. Like, I am definitely one in the boat of people who were disappointed with the lack of screen time that Kate and Anthony had. I liked their storyline. I didn't mind the changes from the book, actually. Like, again, it makes for more drama. In the books, like, Edwina was chill about Kate and Anthony. But then it's like, yeah, like, the books are a different medium, okay? We all know why we read the books. We know why. To get to the juicy parts, okay? Even though we have juicy parts in the show as well, but I think it doesn't really translate well on screen if there's too many juicy parts, because then it'll just get repetitive. Kind of like in the first season where they're just doing it all over the place. It's kind of like Yeah, at first you're like, okay, but after a while you're like, can we get some other drama, right? Because in the end, we watch it for the drama. Yeah, so I want to see blissfully married Kate and Anthony. Just interested to see how they are involved in the love story, because just like how Daphne, I did really like Daphne's involvement in Anthony's story in season 2. So I am looking forward to how Anthony and Kate might influence the other stories, because I understand that they were quite prominent in the books as well, because they are the head of the family now. So I am looking forward to seeing them more. I really like the trope of friends to lovers story. I think in the trope of friends to lovers, the most important thing is, or like unrequited love or like secret crush, there's always the development of, so for Colin is him realizing his feelings, right, and seeing her in a different light, and for Penelope to also see him in a different light and not to put him on a pedestal, because there's no balance. You have to see the real person, you know, to actually have it real, like a real love story. So I am excited to see, like in the trailer when they're like, okay, we are friends, when they shake hands, I am interested to see them being friends, like Penelope getting over her crush on Colin and kind of being practical and wanting to get married and not necessarily with Colin. And I want to see how that plays out. I think that could be really interesting. They will finally see each other as they are. So maybe Colin will see Penelope as not just some like good friend he can wave off, or like, you know, like just, ah, Penelope's sweet. So see him to desire her, basically. That's all what we want to see, right? Like how much Anthony desired Kate. Like we want to see that desire. Like ultimately, that's what Bridgerton is about. Desire. But also love. Also see Penelope's desire. Because so far she has like a very childlike, like a schoolgirl kind of crush. I want to see her grow up as well as a woman and get freaky. I also like that in the trailer that Eloise is very concerned about the possibility of like Colin being a Penelope and how that dynamic will change, how her reaction would be to that. And again, I like to see how Penelope and Eloise will reconcile the relationship and mend their relationship, especially since we've seen the history of their friendship since season 1, right? I'm interested to see the more adult side of their friendship and how they will reconcile. Yeah, unlike with Colin, we actually see Penelope's relationship with Eloise progress and then, you know, how it ended in season 2 with a big blowout fight. So I'm interested in them trying to find a way. I'm trying to see how Penelope can make it up to Eloise. I don't have any predictions for her and Eloise, which is why I'm so interested to see how things play out. Because what is in it for Eloise? What's in it for Eloise to forgive her? Brother's happiness? Right? Maybe Cressida will do something to Eloise and Penelope saves her. It's like maybe they're chummy now, and then Cressida does typical Cressida shit and Penelope comes to the rescue, and then they're like, oh, I miss you. Maybe that is what's going to happen. But yeah, so I'm interested to see two friendships. So Penelope and Eloise, and to actually see Penelope and Colin being friends and know each other on a deeper level. Pun intended. Francesca, I'm also quite excited to see Francesca, especially how like the clips that we've seen of her, like she's reserved as well, but I think the difference between her and Penelope is that she is getting attention because she is on the dance floor, but she doesn't seem all right with the attention. She doesn't seem like she likes the attention. It could be like the opposite of what Daphne experienced. Like Daphne really played her cards with being the diamond, right? But then maybe Francesca will have like the same kind of admiration, especially now that, because Daphne's obstacle was Anthony, right? Because Anthony was standing in the way for the most part. So now that Anthony is happy, he probably wouldn't stand in her way. So interested to see how she handles the attention. And especially since we see the scene that was released, how Francesca wants to take a moment alone and she tells Anthony, and Anthony's like, okay, like, of course. So growth, good job. married Anthony. Woohoo! I do wonder if there's going to be any Kate and Penelope interaction, because I do like Kate and Eloise's interaction so far. So maybe she will be the one advising Eloise on her season or on her friendship with Penelope. Like maybe Kate is the one that Eloise can turn to during this season. So yeah, I'm interested to see that. I know that Daphne is not going to be involved anymore. I mean, I'm not very interested in Daphne and Simon anyway. Like, boring. Okay. Who else? We haven't seen any Gregory, and I do understand that, like, Gregory is a lot younger, but I have heard of Gregory's storyline, so I am wondering if Gregory is, like, the understanding is that Gregory admires Kate and Anthony's relationship and their love story. So I do wonder if part of, like, their love story, like, Gregory's gonna be there, just like, oh, it's like if he's gonna be the audience, you know, like he's gonna be representing us watching Kate and Anthony. They didn't show anything in the trailer, but that is something that I would like to see, maybe. Yeah. Oh, it's also nice to see how Portia is happy for Penelope. I know people complain about Featherington sticking up screen time, myself included. But I do actually like Portia. And again, it's the same reason as Penelope. Like, I think, like, she is very complex, and I do like to see that. Oh yeah, and they added, like, a... How can I forget? They are adding, like, a love interest for Penelope, for Colin to get jealous, basically, right? I am interested to see him. I wonder if they will go with the season one route where the prince is basically a good guy, and I think the foreshadowing was in season two, like, the queen wanted to introduce the prince to Edwina, which I want to see that. I wonder if they're going to bring that back in season three, like, as, like, a surprise, like, if there's going to be a sprinkle of Edwina meeting the prince. That'll be interesting. That will be interesting. That, because I do like Edwina. I know some people don't like her, but I do like her. Like, I think the parts that people dislike Edwina for, her basically getting in the way and her reaction to Kate liking Anthony, I think, like, she was completely justified to be upset. Like, she was built up to find a husband, a good husband, and she saw it in Anthony because he was the one that she was interested enough in, and I think she had every right to have her feelings hurt and to feel betrayed. Because, like, and she also came around pretty fast, so, like, I don't really understand the Edwina hate, but yeah. So, if I get to see more Edwina and the prince, that'll be interesting to see. Yeah, so side characters. So, I do wonder if this new, like, love interest for Penelope, like, if it's gonna be, like, a good love interest that, like, he's gonna get his heart broken, but Polin belong together anyway, you know? Or is he gonna have an ulterior motive, you know? I hope that he's just a good guy, because I think if he has an ulterior motive, then it kind of, I don't know, it kind of sets the tone of Penelope not being desirable enough for anybody. So, yeah. So I do hope that he doesn't end up being a villain, even though it could go that way. But yeah. Yes. So who else? I'm looking forward to seeing more Violet and Lady Danbury, because I really like their friendship. I really like their dynamic. And even though, like, they don't really have a lot going on in their lives, because the stories are about people getting married, I do want to see, like, I wonder if they're gonna have a continuation of their story from Queen Charlotte, because, like, you know, with the whole, like, Violet being horny, basically. I wonder if they're gonna touch on that, on Violet being horny. That would be hilarious. And it'd be, yeah, like, you know, we don't need, like, all the screen time for, like, Featherington's. We don't need it, okay? We don't need it as much. I understand we will need Featherington's because it is Penelope's story, but yeah. I wonder if Violet is gonna take a lover. Because she will definitely be in the story since Francesca is in the is Francesca's season. Like, not Francesca's season, but like Francesca's come out, right? So I do wonder how much of it she's involved in. And I do wonder if we will see Francesca's story, like how much we will see, how far they're going to go into the story of Francesca, because spoiler alert, like her story starts when her husband dies. So I wonder if we will see her first husband, or like, I don't think she meets her husband immediately after she comes out, like after her season. So yeah, we might not be able to see, but I do wonder if there's gonna be a masquerade ball where Benedict sees Sophie. And I do wonder how Benedict is gonna be, because I think the way he ended last season is like, you know, him being disappointed that he got accepted to school because of Anthony and not out of his own artistic capabilities. So I do want to wonder, I have no idea what his story is going to be, honestly. Is he just going to be cute, you know, as Benedict has been for the past two years? Or are they going to like hint what his struggles are for his love story, right? Because like his love story is like a Cinderella story, so it's gonna be a class thing. So I wonder if they're gonna show more of his classism, because right now he's very cool and he hangs out with different people, and so I wonder if they will show that Benedict is like a classist guy. He can hang out with different people in specific areas, but will he actually accept them in his existence outwardly, right? Because that is essentially his story. I do wonder if they're gonna like sprinkle hints of it and like what his struggles are. Or they could just not hint anything, like with Colin, like they did not hint anything about him except for like him traveling and him coming back, him being changed by his travels, I think. So like, I think they hint that he's changed by what he sees in the world. So maybe some trauma. They hint at it. So maybe we'll just get hints of it for this season. But then like, because Anthony had a whole arc in season one, right, to prepare for season two. Like, we see events of season one impacted his decisions in season two, which is why he was so fixated on Edwina, right? So I wonder if that, if Benedict is gonna get the Anthony treatment, or is he gonna get the Colin treatment, and we don't really see that much before his story. But yeah, so I think those are the things I'm looking forward to, and I am excited. I do wonder, I'm still on the fence about Polin, but I have a feeling that I'll end up loving them, but we'll see. We'll see. I just hope that the things I've mentioned are gonna get addressed in the season. I am really excited for Penelope to take the lead. I'm not gonna lie, like, even though I know I said that I don't like Penelope, but I do really like Nicola, and I think she portrays Penelope really well. And also I like the short representation. Okay, she's really short, like her height difference from like Colleen. I'm just wondering like how the framing is gonna be throughout the entire season. Like, coming from a short girl, okay, who has struggles with framing with taller people as well. So yeah, excited to see that in terms of like cinematography. Oh, also costumes. I don't care about historical accuracy because it's Bridgerton. They're just there to look fabulous, and I want them to all look fabulous. I hope you are as excited for Bridgerton season 3 as I am. I might do a reaction like series watching it. I don't know, who knows, because I might be watching it with my friend as well. So if I watch it with my friend, then it might be more difficult for me to film a reaction. But yeah, excited. Okay, bye bye.